Hello friends, welcome to my another lecture on Prepare for Programming Aptitude. This is a lecture series that we are doing for campus placement and out of that programming aptitude. So in this particular lecture series, our intention is to learn how to write the effective programs. So dear friends, if you want to interact with me directly face to face, you can join my Telegram channel. The link to join the Telegram channel is provided in the description section of this particular video. Dear friends, in this particular video, we are going to discuss about how the variable names are given, what are the different keywords that cannot be used as a variables, what are the different operators generally we use to perform the calculations, and we will, along with that, we will discuss some 4 to 5 simple programs. So in the, you can go through my last 2 programs, whatever, if you want to go through them, like what is the format of NQT is discussed in my first lecture. In the last lecture, we have discussed about the structure of a C programming language. So we are moving ahead and we will go on increasing the complexity of the programs lecture by lecture. So friends, let us start and let us first in this particular lecture discuss about the rules for constructing the variable names. So any variable, so whenever you want to declare a variable, that variable name, what is the maximum length of the variable name that can be given is, it is up to 31 characters. So you can give it up to 1 to 31 character. So the length of the variable will be from, minimum length will be of 1 character and maximum will be 31 character. The variable always starts, the first character of the variable must be a letter. Always it must be a letter. No commas and blanks are allowed within the variable name. And again, no symbols are allowed. What is allowed is first letter must be a character. And after that, you can have alphanumerical character. So it can be a small letter, or it can be a capital letter, or it can be a letter, it can be a digit. Okay. And any number of digits. It is any number of digits, except special characters like @, hash, percentage. All these letters are not allowed in the name of the identifier or variable name. Okay, only one special symbol, that is _, is allowed. Okay, so these are the some of the valid declarations of the variable. So si_interest. So this si_interest, it is represented in this way that it shows that it is for simple interest. So you should take care that whenever you are declaring the variable, you should be able to identify for what purpose we are declaring that variable. Okay. Then this mhra is for monthly HRA. So in this way, we have to give the name of the variables. So variables, there are 4 rules. There are 4 rules. One is length is between 1 to 31. Length is between 1 to 31, then it should not contain any commas and blanks, and the first character must be a letter, and others can be alphanumeric value, and no special symbol other than an _ is allowed in the variable declaration. So another thing that we need to understand is about which there are some keywords, and these keywords cannot be used as a variable names. So for example, int is a data type. In order to declare the integer values, we use this particular data type. Double is another data type. If else, so if else can also, you cannot give a variable name as if and else. So these are the keywords. You cannot declare the names of the variables with these keywords. Okay, auto is whenever you want to declare a variable as a auto type, so it will be auto int, something like this. Your declaration will be auto int. Break is used in the looping statement to come out of the loop. I will tell you what is a loop. So when a particular set of instruction, let us say there are 5 instructions, and you are executing it repeatedly, and you want to come out of it at that time, so manually if you want to come out of it, you will require a break. Then case is a conditional statement. Then character is a variable declaration. Constant is to declare a variable as a constant. You cannot change the value of a constant variable. Continue is to, so as break is to come out of it, continue is to continue with this, and so on. So these are for loop. For is the we can say looping statement and all. So these are some of the keywords, and these keywords should not be used as a variable name of the variable. So let us try to understand about which are the basic operators that we use. In order to add the numbers, we use a plus. The example for this is, if you want to add two numbers a and b, you will use it as c is equal to a and b. The value of a and b will be added and it will be stored to c. If you want to add five numbers, then in that case it will be a c is equal to a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus a4 plus a5. So a1, a2, a3, a4, a5, these are all the variables, memory locations. And so the variable name can be a as well as a1. In any way, minus is used for subtraction, divide is used for division. So for example, 25 divided by 5 will give you 5. Divide will give you 5. Multiplication, star is used for multiplication. Then percentage is used to find out the remainder. Now here 25, so it is read as mod 5 is equal to 0. So when 25 is divided by 5, 5 is 25, what is the remainder? What is the remainder? So in order to get the remainder, we use a symbol mod. Then we have an ampersand. This is logical and this is logical OR. So for two statements, you want that in a conditional statement, both the statements should be true to proceed ahead. So at that time you can use the condition and you can use OR when any one of them is. So we will discuss the examples based on these two operators. These are the basic operators. Other operators, whenever needed, I'll talk about them. Let us start with a simple program. So a program wherein we want to find out average of five numbers. Over here we want to read, let us say, five different values. So these are the five different subjects for a given student, and I'll be reading the marks to these five subjects, and then I'll finding the average of all these five numbers. So this is part is called as an algorithm. So as I have told in the last lecture, that whenever you want to write a program, you have to think about the logic of that. So how it is going to work is, first of all, take five subjects or take five values. It is take five values. Okay, assign value to the variables and then calculate total, and average is equal to total divided by 5, and then display the result. This is called as a flowchart. So an oval indicates the start or end. So before oval, whatever the instructions are written, they are not going to be executed. After this particular oval, whatever the instruction they are written, they will not be executed. Now here, read the 5 values. So this type of symbol in a flowchart is used for reading and displaying. So input and output is represented by this, and any calculation if you are doing, you have to represent it inside the rectangle. So in the rectangle I am doing these calculations. So friends, let us go to the at the programming part, and let us try to run and execute this particular code. So over here, as you can see, I am using the same line compiler to implement the program. So int, I want to find out the average of five numbers here. So what I have to do is, I have to read five variables. So let us read them as integer type: int a, b, c, d, and I'll read out all these values. So printf, read the values of A, B, C, E and E. This is the message which should be prompted to the user, and now the user has to read the value. He has to enter the value. So here we'll use the scanf function. Always remember that whatever the printf function is there, whatever the scanf function is there, that should be in the small letters only. I want to read 5 values now, so it will be %d for 5 times. You can write them with the space or without the space. Only the thing is that now you have to give the proper comma and the space. So ampersand a small letter, ampersand b, then ampersand c, ampersand d, ampersand e, semicolon after this. After this I want to find out that sum. So in order to use sum as a variable over here, what I have to do is I have to declare it here, then integer sum and average. So sum is equal to, I want to add all this, so sum is equal to a plus b plus c plus d plus e semicolon, and average is equal to sum divided by 5. Average is equal to sum divided by 5. So let us so this is how we implement it, and let us try to execute this particular program and let us try to see what results we get. So let us say we run the program, and there are some errors over here. What are the errors? So there is a comma missing after b. Over here you can see there is a comma missing after b, so I'll give a comma over here. Let us run this program. So running means you have to compile it. So capital S I have taken here, while declaration small sum is there, but here I have taken the capital sum, so that S to be made the small letter. Then again let us compile and run it. So now read the values of A, B, C, D and E. So let us take the values as 4, 6, 8, 10, and let us take another one, 2. Another one is 2. Once I enter, so only the values have been read, but there is no output. But why there is no output is because we have not displayed the output. So we have calculated it. So we have to display it. In order to display it, we have to write another printf statement. Is printf sum is equal to %d, and after this I want to go to a new line, so for that I will add a backslash n, and average is equal to again %d. The values are sum and average. Again let us execute this. So read the values of A, B, C and D. So let me enter the 5 values, 4, 6, 8, 2 and 5. 4, 6, 8, 2 and 5. I enter. So what I get is sum is equal to 25, average is equal to 5. So 25 divided by 5, because we have 5 values. So that's the reason that we are dividing it by 5 over here. If we had 6 values, in that case we have to divide it by 6. So this is how it works. But there is some problem in this program. And what is that problem in this program? I will show you. If I take some other values, wherein the average is not perfect integer, so for example if I take 3, 4, 5 and then 6 and 6, okay, and if I take 5 values over here, in that case, so the sum is 24 and average is 4. Actually average should be 24 divided by 5, it should be somewhere 4.8 will be, so 40. So average is 20. When we do 24 divided by 5, it is 4.8. It should be 4.8, but it is giving 4 as an answer. Why it is doing that is because I have defined this average as a integer. So in order to get the floating point values, correct floating point value. Either one thing I can do is I can declare all these values as a float, and now if I'll run it, you can see. So now here, yes, if I declare all these as a float, I cannot make them as a percent D here. I have to change them, all of them, to the percentage F. So first of all, let me stop here and then convert all the percent D to percent F. And here, wherever there are percent D, you have to convert them to percent F. Because now the variable has been changed. The variable has been changed. Run it. And we enter 5 values now. Let's enter 5 values. The same 5 values. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let us enter this. So the number is 25. Again it is 25. So 25 will get 5. So let us give some other value. Let us say 4, 4, 5, 6. Not be perfect this one. So 4 plus 10, 10, and this one is 9. And let us give 3. Now the sum is 22 and it is 4.40. You can see here. It is 4.40. But there are 6 digits have been displayed. If you want to display the limited number of digits at that time, what you can do is you can write it as percentage 0.2f, percent 2f. Similarly here, percent 2f. Okay. So here, if we'll run it again, and if we'll enter 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, let us see. So it is 18 and 3.60. That's the value. 2.2. It is only two values, percent 0.2 is to be given here. I hope you understood this particular program. Again, another way is there wherein you will declare all these values as an integer, a, b, c, d, e, and sum, and you will convert the integer type to float type by using the type conversion. Okay, I will do that program separately. Okay, for now, this is the average of 5 numbers. So what you can do is you can write down this one into your notebook to practice this better. Let us move ahead and let us discuss another program. The program is area of circle or triangle or rectangle. So here again you have to read the values. So whenever you want to find out the area of circle or let us say area of circle, the formula is pi r square. Radius is to be read from the user. Pi, value of pi is 22/7 fixed, and whatever the radius value is entered, we have to multiply it for 2 times. For the area of triangle, so it is 1/2 length into breadth, okay, length into height, and for rectangle it is length into height. So we will discuss only one program for circle, and then in the same program we will try to add on this one, or I will try to explain you how to implement this. Okay, so again let us go back to that programming part. So over here, now my intention is to find out the area of circle. So for area of circle, what we require is we require a radius. So I will declare float f. Okay, so radius can be it will not be always an integer, and I will declare another variable area, then printf. For the value of radius, we have to read it. So for reading it, scanf. Only one value I am reading here. Percentage f, because I have read the floating point value. So percentage f comma ampersand r. Then area is equal to 22 divided by 7, that comes to be 3.142 somewhere. But always take the 22 by 7 whenever you are computing it on a computer, because it will give you a more accurate value. So 22 by 7 into r. So this is how we can calculate the area. And after calculating the area, we have to display the value of the area. So again printf area of circle with radius. So if you want to print the radius here, %d is equal to %d. So first %d is radius value and second %d is area value. So it is actually, it should be %f, because it is a floating point value. So the first one is r and second one is area. Bring a semicolon here and let us try to run this program now. We may get some this one. So ampersand r. So it is f here. We declare it as r. Then let us run here and enter the value of radius. The radius, if I take 5 cm, let us say 5, so the area of circle is 75. So 75 is 22 by 7 into 5 into 5. That comes to be 75. Okay. What was the problem? Problem was, I was dividing integer value by integer value. I was expecting an integer, and due to that I was getting 75 as an answer over there. Now, so we need to change. We need to make each and every point as a float value. So for that purpose, 22.0 divided by 7.0 into r into r is been done here. And if we try to run this program now, so if I enter area of circle is equal to 4, the radius of the circle is equal to 4. In that case, it will be this area of the circle with radius 4 is 50.285713. So this is how we implement for this. And now let us consider it for area of rectangle. So you can write it down into your notebook if you want. Let me save it my file so that I can share it to you all later on. Again coming back. So let us now implement it for area of rectangle. So for area of rectangle, we require length and height. For the circle one, if you want to calculate the circumference here, this is now circle. I'll continue with the circle only. If you want to calculate the circumference here, so you can also calculate the circumference of the circle by using this one. CIR. So circumference is equal to pi r, 2 pi r. So it is 2.0. multiplied by pi. Pi is 22 by 7, so 22.0 divided by 7.0 multiplied by r. So it is 2 pi r. And you can also print the circumference. So circumference is equal to circumference of the circle is equal to percentage f. So at the same, this one, same program I have tried to explain the both of them. So now if I run it, and if I'll give the value of the radius is equal to 5, it will calculate the circumference as well as the area of the circle, and it will display the both. Display the both. There is one compilation fault, SCIR. So it is not declared. Let us declare it. So any variable which you want to use is to be declared first. Okay. Digif, and here circumference value is to be displayed. Now let us run it. There is another error, printf, semicolon is missing. Identified, removed. Now again try to compare, and now it is asking for a radius. Enter the radius is equal to 5. It will give you area of the circle with 5 is 78.57 and the circumference is equal to 31. Now if you want to bring this one into the next line, you can add a backslash n here. And again, if you run it, you will get 78 and circumference is equal to 31.42. So this is how we can calculate the circumference and the radius of a circle. We will do it for area of rectangle. I want you to do the area of triangle on your own. So only there will be a small difference in the formula. In the area of rectangle, we read length and height. So float length, float height, and the area. The area. If it is a square, in that case, length is equal to height, and that multiplication can be there. Then enter the value of here you can say that L and H, and here you can read two values now are to be read. So percent F, one is L, percentage L, and second one is percent H. And here area is equal to length multiplied by height. So it is so simple, length multiplied by height. Then circumference is not to be calculated. I will put it into the comment section, area of the rectangle. Rectangle is equal to, if you want to print the values of length L and H, you can print them also, but here I want directly to print the value of the area, and again this I am not going to be executing, so I'll put that into the comment section. So now let us try running it. So while executing it, you may incur some errors. Since I have a practice of better programming, whenever you are doing it, you have to do it in separate program. So start it from the beginning. So if let us enter length is equal to 4 and height is equal to 6, how the area of rectangle is calculated is length multiplied by height, and area of the rectangle is 4 into 6, that comes to be 24. Now here if you want to write only two digits, so at that time we can write it as percentage 0.2d. One digit will be 0.1, and after that if you run it, length is equal to 4, height is equal to 6, area of the rectangle is 24. Similarly, if you want to do it for area of circle, in that case it will be 1 by 2 into L into H. Only this change will be there. You have to read the two values, same two values, and it will become different values. After this, let us move ahead and let us try to understand other programs. Like we can write all these programs in the same way. So cylinder, so volume of a cylinder, if you want to find out the volume of a cylinder, you have to read two values. One is radius of the cylinder and height of the cylinder, and you have to apply pi into r square into h into that coding section, into that formula. Then volume of the sphere, 4 into pi into r into r divided by 3. Volume of a cone will be in this way. Volume of a cube, you have to read only one value here, and the side value, and its cube is to be taken. So S into S into S. Then hemisphere, 2 by 3. Now what is a hemisphere? It is some cut of a circle. Circle cut it. It is a circle cut. So a playing ball, okay, on an earth, when it is cut at a particular line. So at that time some hemisphere will be generated, and what is the volume of that hemisphere, it can be calculated as radius of that circle multiplied by pi multiplied by 2/3. Similarly, you can calculate the circumference of the circle that we have seen, and you can also calculate the simple interest. So our next lecture will be on conditional statements, but before moving on to the next lecture, we will have a simple program on one program on volume and one program on simple interest. So let us do that also today itself. So let us move on and let us calculate the simple interest now. For simple interest, so what is the simple interest is? Simple interest is your amount invested multiplied by the time and the rate. Okay, so in the simple interest, what we want to calculate is, we want to calculate simple interest is equal to, simple interest is equal to P into R into T, where P is a principal amount, R is a rate of interest, and T is a time, divided by 100. So what we have to read is, we have to read P, we have to read R, and we have to read T, and we have to multiply all these factors and divide it by 100. So the values that are to be read is P R T, P R comma R comma T, and SI. I want to calculate simple interest, so that will also come. Then after that, printf, enter the value of P R T, P comma R comma T, then we'll read the values of P, R and T. So we need to read three values here. So three times percentage F, and ampersand P, ampersand R, and ampersand T. Three values, three memory locations are to be read. Then simple interest is equal to, we have to apply here. Simple interest is equal to SI is equal to, so we'll remove this part. Simple interest is equal to SI is equal to P multiplied by R multiplied by T. So P multiplied by R multiplied by T divided by 100. So divided by is slash divided by 100. Okay. And the simple interest is equal to, you can write here, simple interest is equal to is equal to percentage F SI. So let us run this. What you will find is, there is a error on printf, and what it says is, there is a semicolon missing before printf. So before this this printf, this is a printf, and before this there is an instruction, and for that I have missed the semicolon. Correct it and again compile it. So enter the value of PRT. So principal amount we'll consider as 1500 rupees. Then rate of interest we'll consider as 8%, and time we'll consider as 2 years, let us say. So total simple interest comes to be 240. You can see here, 100 and 500 multiplied by 8 multiplied by 2. So 1500 multiplied by 8 comes to be 12,000 multiplied by 2, 24,000 divided by 100. So that comes to be 240. So this is how we calculate the simple interest of the particular program. Similarly, if we want to calculate the volume of a, let us say, cylinder, volume of a cylinder. So I'll eliminate all this because this can create a confusion. So volume of a cylinder, let us do it for volume of a cylinder. So for cylinder, what we require? We require radius and height. So you can see here, so for volume of a cylinder, it is pi into r square into h. Pi into r square into h, volume of a cylinder. So over here, it is pi r square. So we need to declare all the variables. Int, we require a r. We require h, and we require a volume V. Okay. Def. Here the value of R and H. That is radius and height. Then scanf. We need to read two values now. So that will be percentage F. Percentage F. Two values are R, ampersand R, and ampersand H. Then volume is equal to pi. Pi is 22.0 divided by 7.0 multiplied by r square. Now 2 times multiplied r. R into h. You can confirm it here. It is pi r square h. So that is r into h. And you will print the value here. Print f. Volume of sphere. Is equal to right over here. Volume of a square is equal to percentage D. It is not percentage D, it is percentage F. Comma is volume V. Volume. Close the bracket, semicolon, and run it. We get some errors. So one error is percentage F warning. So there are some warnings. So there is one error. Error V undeclared. So V volume. It is actually volume. If there are any errors, you can ignore them. So enter the value of R and H. So here it is asking. You can see here. So I will enter R is equal to 5 and H is equal to 7. We enter it. So we get an answer here. Enter the value of R and H, 5, 7. The volume of the sphere is 0 we are getting. Okay. Let me check what is the problem here. Okay. The problem here is I have declared these are as int and I am taking it as float f. So I have to declare this variable, all these variables as float only. I have to declare them as float only. Let us run it. And r is, let us now define r is equal to 4 and h is equal to 7. So the value is 3, the volume is 352. So this is cubic centimeter. So if the values, input values are in centimeters, it will, the output is in cubic centimeters. Okay. So here in this particular lecture we have discussed the different types of how to declare the variables, then what are all the keywords, so declaration of the variables, rules for constructing the variable, then we discussed about keywords, then we discussed about the operators, basic operators, some flowcharts and algorithms we have discussed, and we have tried to understand how the simple programs can be written. So we are stopping in this particular lecture here only, and in the next lecture we will understand the conditional statements, and based on that we will try to implement the problems and programs based for the programs which requires the conditional statements. The programs can be finding out whether a given number is even or odd, or whether checking whether it is let us say negative or positive, checking again whether like based on conditions, like if I am purchasing 5 units of soap, at the time I will be getting 5% of discount, but if I am buying 10 units of soap, in that case I will be getting 10% of discount. So based on how much amount of soaps I have considered, let us say how much amount of discount on the price I should get. So all such type of problems we will discuss in the next video lecture. Thank you for attending this particular lecture.